Today, I'd like to help you understand how the baby makes his or her way through the mother's pelvis in labour. And there are some important points to note and some helpful points. Let's start with the baby. So I have a doll here to illustrate a few important points about newborn babies or babies in the womb. So obviously the shoulders are biggest from side to side, and that will be important later. But let's have a look at the head, and this isn't quite so obvious. The head is smallest from one side to the other side compared to how big it is from one, the front versus the back. So smaller from side to side, bigger from front to back. And a baby's head is not fused like our skull. It has four separate plates, and those plates can move to make the baby's head narrower, longer and narrower, to make it easier to get through the pelvis during labour and birth. Then we have the pelvis. And in terms of size, the pelvis is biggest on the inlet at the top. So from side to side at the top, that's the biggest dimension compared to front to back. That's quite a bit smaller. In the middle, it's around the same, it's circular. At the outlet, it's a little bit harder to see, but it is narrower, smaller from side to side compared to front to back. So it's bigger from the front here at the pubic bone all the way back to the coccyx, especially if the coccyx is free to move. And the coccyx is always more free to move in upright positions, such as all fours, kneeling over a birth ball, maybe kneeling, leaning over the back of the bed, compared to the position that's often portrayed on TV, which is that lying back propped up position where the coccyx and sacrum aren't as free to move. So let's see how the baby makes his or her way through the pelvis. And we have to arrange the doll in the right position. So the baby has his chin tucked on his chest so that this part of the head, the occiput, is forming a wedge against the cervix. And the baby's head enters the inlet of the pelvis in the way that suits the dimensions of the head best. So the baby is entering with the biggest part of his head from front to back, lining up with the biggest part of the pelvis, which is side to side. And as the contractions start to push him down further, his head meets the resistance of the pelvic floor, especially if it's nice and taut. Sometimes an epidural can relax the tone of the pelvic floor, and these turns are not quite as efficient sometimes. So he meets the resistance of the pelvic floor, and that causes him to turn his body, his head and body, which is great because now the shoulders are nicely lined up to enter the biggest part of the pelvis. So the shoulders are lined up side to side with the pelvis. Then the baby's head is born, and he arches his head up into the pubic arch. So this is an instinctive behavior. He arches his head up into the pubic arch, and that pulls his shoulders down to the pelvic floor where they meet the resistance of the pelvic floor, and further uterine contractions cause another turn. So as you can see, the baby's head is born with his face facing his mother's backside. But as then that second turn occurs with the shoulders, and one shoulder is born and then the other shoulder, the baby is born side on to his mother's legs and then up for skin to skin. And as I said in another separate video, skin to skin is very protective for the mother to reduce her risk of hemorrhage.